Quinton, thank you very much for joining us today. Great performance yesterday. Tell us about your experience of the conditions and just how you went about it as a batsman.
That was obviously a turning wicket, so obviously I had to bring out the sweeps and reverse sweeps just to nullify the spin a bit. That's pretty much it, just make sure it's key that you just keep ticking them over with singles outside the park against the spinners. Didn't want to get to bog down. That's pretty much it. It was a low total, so I was never in a rush to get to the total. Could take my time, so I could choose my balls that I wanted to take on. That's pretty much that. Just making sure I bat through. Just keep that just on a total like that someone just bats through the whole way. So that's all I was just thinking of doing.
It's good to see the batsman in good nick as well. Do you have a comment on guys like Reza and Aiden and the way that they batted yesterday?
I think the guys have been working hard, not just on this tour but previous tours. It has been highlighted. Our play against spin on turning wickets, so the guys have worked really hard and it's now starting to show signs, especially due to Sri Lanka in their own conditions. As you can see, these haven't been easy wickets. All the batsmen, not just Adam and Reza, have all improved. They really showed a lot of people how to play spin, at least that's what I feel. Seeing it from the side, they made it look really easy, even though I know it's not. It's good to see that the guys that improve, when they improve and working hard, that they're getting they're getting it done. So it's just good to see.
How do you balance patience when you're trying to score runs, as well as the urgency that comes with the format of T20 cricket?
To be honest, I've played so much T20 that I've realised that you actually have more time than you think. 120 balls is actually quite a lot. It doesn't sound like a lot, but once you're out there, once you understand the game, you can realise that you actually have more time than you think. That's pretty much what I've just learned over the years. It's pretty much that.
You've matured quite a lot as well. You used to be, very impatient with your game. And how much of the game time that you have received or been able to have contributes to that?
I think, like I said, I think it's just because I've played so much T20 cricket and I've experienced a lot more. It's compared to when I was younger. I think I'm just another one of those guys who wish what I knew now, I wish I knew when I was 21, 22. Unfortunately, that's not the case. So I think it's just learning from my past mistakes, my experiences. I think it's now starting to, obviously learning from them. I just want to score runs, I guess. Obviously now, as we've kind of seen, as one of the leaders in the batting lineup, got to hold on to that and just be the best person I can be.
You're not as old as a lot of people would think, considering how much cricket that you've played. But how does it feel to be, still in your 20s, but being referred to as, one of the leaders and a senior player in this team?
I think in the cricket world, I'm still like a youngster, but I think just because of the nature of the team, obviously a 28-year-old is quite a similar guy at this team, the way they look out at as the team. We've got a lot of new guys who haven't played a lot of T20 cricket, or guys are still learning their own game. So, I think about 5, 6, 7 years ago, I think if you were 28, you were a youngster in the team, then you were surrounded by A.B., Graham, those guys. Now it's the other way. So, I'm chilled about it. I am 28, I'm still very young in this game, so I still got quite a bit to learn, quite a lot more to achieve, so.
Still very young at heart as well?
Very young still. 21 in my own heart, forever.
I love that. Obviously the team is looking to clinch this have a 3-0 sweep. How do you guys go about making sure that you achieve that?
Oh, just to be honest, just to do the same thing we've been doing, consistency. I think that's pretty much it. Yeah, just don't get too ahead of ourselves, or don't get ahead of ourselves at all. And just getting the job done, because I think the confidence is high at the moment, just mustn't take it for granted. Yeah, like I said, just consistency, just keep doing what you're doing.
A lot of people take for granted the fact that the team has won 3 T20 series in a row away from home. How big is that to you guys?
No, it's big. I think there has been question marks of late of our form away from home, and now to actually start producing from our hard work, start winning series is a big thing, especially in subcontinent tours. Sri Lanka is never an easy place to win a series. As you saw on the one days, it's always difficult. They always spin the conditions into their favour. So for us to come out and actually really, to have such a convincing win over some subcontinent is a big thing. But like I said, it's all about consistency now going forward and just to keep it going.
T20 World Cup coming up. Are you excited to be able to represent your country in another ICC event?
Yeah, to be honest, I'm actually pretty chilled right now. There's still 2 months away. When it all comes together at that point in time, the World Cup, I'm sure I'll be excited. I'll definitely be waiting and ready for it. My hunger to win a World Cup is always up there, especially with this team. I've got a great feeling about this team. I think we're heading in the right direction. I'm excited, but no nerves, none of that stuff has settled in.
You've won an IPL, we've won 2, you've won 100. Do you feel as though that the time is right for an ICC event?
Yeah, I think it would be great to put one of those in the bag. I've been part of a couple now, and sadly we've come up short in all of them. Obviously some great games in the past and ICC events, and a lot of disappointments. But like I said, I'd love to put one in the bag, but it's a big tournament. There's a lot of good players representing their country. We're going to give it our best shot, that's for sure. We're going to try our hardest. That's what you can do, and hopefully the results come our way.
How's Quinton de Kock doing as a human being right now with the baby on the way?
Very, very chill. It's still a long time. I'm absolutely easy. Life still carries on for me. I'm not the one carrying the baby, so my life is still easy. Pretty chilled. Not nervous, not excited or anything yet. Like I said, still a long time.
Excited to be a girl dad?
No.
Do you have a shotgun yet?
I know exactly what goes on.
But yourself and Sasha are doing really well.
Yeah, for now. We're doing really well. Obviously, her being pregnant struggles with certain things, but that's just the nature of being pregnant. At the moment we're doing really well, and she's very excited. Did a lot of shopping, that's for sure. Love those small things, and mood swings, what it all comes with. It's good so far.
And just finally, the mood in the team, how are you seeing everything, particularly after the T20 World Cup squad having been announced?
Yeah, I think there was obviously, we had a couple of guys that I was in the squad that were quite disappointed. I mean, that's just the nature of World Cup teams and squads. Everybody gets disappointed, but then there were some really excited guys. Guys who were disappointed, we just gave them a bit of love, which they needed, I thought. But other than that, the team's in a good space at the moment. I think the team's really excited. Some guys are representing South Africa in their first ever World Cup. There's a couple of guys who've been in a couple and are just as excited. So hopefully we just take this confidence from this series, particularly, and just take it into the World Cup.